Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. I hope you're having a fantastic day. Today is Saturday, and it's the last Saturday that I may have off at the car dealership. I usually always work Saturdays, but after the last 8 weeks or so of not working a routine schedule, I kind of like not working Saturdays. So 20 years I've worked Saturdays in the car business, and I don't know. We're not feeling it next weekend. So we'll see what happens. But today I'm really excited because we're going to go to a little kid's birthday party. So we're just gonna like do drive-bys. You've seen these on the internet all over the place. And so we're gonna take the C8. I was asked to bring the C8 out. There's gonna be a bunch of other supercars. So I don't know anybody here. I haven't met anybody that I know of. Maybe some of you will show up because I do know some Lamborghini and Ferrari people, but that's what's gonna be there. And I'm really excited to get going in the car and do something special for this little kid who can't have a real birthday party. It's got to be a bummer to be a kid and not have a birthday party due to COVID-19. So we're gonna hop in the C8 and off we go. But first, let's get a cold start. We do have some great news about the exhaust coming. Soul Performance has shipped my Sport Cats. I'm really excited to put those on. I may just do it myself. They look pretty easy. I was kind of poking around in there, and just outside of probably having to take the rear fascia off and the trunk out and stuff like that, I think it's really, really easy. I'm gonna contact them and see what they say and see what they think, but this could be something that you can do in your garage at home if you wanna do this. If I can't do it or don't feel like doing it, then we'll reach out to my boys over in Middletown, Kentucky, and that would be Dynasty. They're the ones who's gonna do all the work on this. We twin turbo it, maybe now pro charge it. Pro charger's working on some stuff. I don't know. We'll just have to see what's going on with their concept, but everybody's twin turbo in the car right now. So to pro charge it might be a little bit different, and that's the way I like it.
What? Get, hey, out of the car. What are you doing? I can't believe you just did that. You've never been in the car. You're a bad dog. You're a bad dog, Porsche. Oh, you're gonna attack, is it Corey's fault? You're gonna attack Corey?
All right, guys, we are here. We're meeting up with just a couple cars right here and then headed over to a gentleman's house that's got a Huracan and a Bentley and whatnot. I do know this gentleman. He's actually buying a car from the dealership, maybe for me. I'm not sure if the salesperson who he originally got in contact with is gonna be the one delivering the car. Hopefully it's me. His car is in at 300,000 status, but
got a little Mustang action here. Got an M5. How much horsepower does that M5 got? 600? All right, so we got a V10 M5 here and a 458 Ferrari. Nice, nice. See what else we got coming in. All right, I got a little Fiat that is with us.
And I don't know if you saw the Maserati a little bit ago. He was leaving. He's gonna catch back up with us here in a second. And so yeah, we got some cool cars coming up. And I know the Lamborghini, the Huracan, it's sick. Wait till you see the interior of this. You may have seen this car in Stradman's video, but yeah, it's pretty sick. All right, guys, we are here. We picked up a California on the way, and we have a R8 Cabriolet back there. All the supercar guys are looking at my car in the new California. Gotta love it. But here's the interesting thing. You guys know that my car will do 270-60. It may not be the fastest car here. It's most likely the cheapest car here, right? But check that out. Yeah, we got a Tesla Model X. P100D, 2.7060. He's gonna get his Lamborghini out, but that would be a little bit more fun to dig. We can't roll race that, but from a dig would be fun.
All right, guys, sadly, the Huracan is out of the garage. I missed it.
That was just dumb of me. I don't know what I'm thinking. I should have came down here and got a cold start on the Huracan. You guys have heard this Huracan before. I know, if I was thinking, Bill. We've heard this Huracan before. This is the one with the green interior.
All right, so So then we've got the rolls. He's got this wrap very, very similar to the Huracan. It's a matte black finish. It's absolutely gorgeous. You always gotta look at the umbrella, right? You always gotta look at the umbrella on the Rolls Royce. Coolest feature on the car. Absolutely beautiful. I don't even know I held that door. I held that door like I wanted to hold it to open it itself, but yeah, gotta love it. And just pulled up is a very, very sweet W12 Bentley. Absolutely. Look at that interior. Oh yeah, love it. All right, guys, we're out of here for the next stop. We're going to a local high school to meet up. So this is a 10-year-old kid. We got some neighbor kids out here with the video camera. All right, so I was saying, the birthday drive-by party is for a 10-year-old kid. So this is really fun that we get to do this for a 10-year-old because this is his big day, right? So this is a big deal for him, right? So presumably this is the only time that he's ever gonna add a digit to his age, unless he lives to be 100. So this is a big time. And I remember when I was 10, that getting from 9 to 10 as an adolescent, that just makes you feel so good, so proud. It's kind of like almost being an adult. So it's awesome that we can do this with this 10-year-old kid. And sounds like he's a big supercar fan. So it's awesome that we have about 15 cars so far that's gonna drive by and show him some love. All right, boys, we are here. We've got a little bit more cars out here at the Oldham County High School. It's gonna be turning out to, ooh, look at that. We got a Camaro, we got a Porsche. So we're gonna have a really good turnout for this car parade for this little 10-year-old boy.
All right, so he said that this car is cooler than that car.
Just is. It just is.
Ford guy. You're a Ford guy too? Yeah. Oh man, even a Ford guy says that.
I work at Ford.
He works at Ford, Ford guy. Love it. This is the birthday boy, guys. What are you, like 3, 4? How old are you?
11.
Oh, you're 11. Oh, they see, he's turning 11, guys. So all that stuff earlier I was talking about being 10. Oh, look, he just hopped in my car. He didn't even ask. He's like, it's my birthday, I'm hopping in.
What do you think? It's like, feel steering wheel? That's Whoa, that must be how you started.
I had a friend who...
Man, how'd you do that? Started it right up.
It's amazing.
All right, so perfect. On your 11th birthday, you're gonna send in a brand new Corvette. So here's what you need to do is, you gotta send it, but you gotta rev it up, right?
Oh, you gotta rev it.
You gotta go rev it up, man. Get in there and rev it up. Here are some good blips.
That one?
Now here, scoot the seat up, man. Get comfortable in there. There you go. Hit it hard. Woo! There you go, that's awesome.
Happy birthday.
Alright, there we go, there we go. Little GT3 RS. Love it. Alright guys, well, this turned out to not be
a drive-by because the 11-year-old kid showed up.
Well, now the cops are here. And they're kicking us off the property.
I don't know if they can. This is public property. All right, guys, we are home. What's up, girls? How are you? How are you, girls? You excited that I'm home? Don't be trying to jump in the car again, Porsche. Oh, look at you. Look at you guys. So there you have it. As you see, I'm home now, but it was a great time. I'm glad I got to be there. Enjoyed letting the kid rev up the engine. It's probably what most supercars owners don't let people do to their cars. Being a little bit different with the car. Not sure why the cop showed up. Well, I kind of do know why. There was idiot people leaving, stopping on this busy road, doing burnouts and racing down the road. And I've never really been to Cars and Coffee. I've been to a couple of them, but obviously I see videos out there on social media, on YouTube and stuff like that. When you go to Cars and Coffee, you don't need to leave like a you know what I'm talking about, right? So I don't understand why people leave car shows, stop, do burnouts, and leave. There's a faster car there all the time. There was a Mustang right across the way from me that was 1,500 horsepower. He left very, very calmly and very, very nicely. So do yourselves a favor. Do the supercar community a favor. Do the car enthusiast community a favor. Leave Cars and Coffee normal. Just go. Hey, if you need to gun it a little bit, hey, get up on the exhaust. Cool. But don't do burnouts. This is the reason the cops came here and ruined this kid's 11-year-old birthday party. Maybe he likes it. I don't know. But the really cool thing is the supercar owners absolutely loved this car. They were really, really impressed. I opened it up. I let everybody look into it. Didn't let too many people sit in it just because we still are in this COVID-19. It wasn't really comfortable being around that many people in that group, but we were outside and I was keeping my distance. But anyways, it was a fun time and I look forward to more Cars and Coffee here in Louisville. That was my first one. And it's really, really exciting. So as always, guys, if this is the first time you're watching the video, make sure you hit the subscribe button because this many people don't subscribe to this channel. And make sure you turn all your bell notifications on as well. As always, thanks again for watching. Have a great day and drive safely.